Namaste. Welcome to Clyde Samvada, brought to you by the Hindu Temple of Scotland. Today we have a very special episode where recently in the temple we performed a Nitya Pooja workshop for children hosted by Dr. Narasimhan.
Namaskaram, Srivatsa. Yes, as part of the Clyde Samvada, I'm glad to have this recorded video program being shared today. This about during the summer holidays, I thought of this idea, how we can engage children to train basic fundamentals in a more classroom conversational way to do the daily puja or what we call Nitya Puja at home, either for Lord Ganesha and Vishnu. So we have two volunteers, one is yourself, Srivatsan, and Sriram demonstrating, and then there were about 30 enthusiastic children learning the workshop of doing the puja at home. I hope this will be of benefit to the people who could not come that day, for both children and their parents, where they can observe this video and try to do at home. We are hoping to bring possibly another episode in the coming months, but this is what the video today we all can watch and get the benefit. I hope you all have a nice experience. Thank you.
Asmat Guruvyo Namaha Om Asmat Kula Devatavyo Namaha Om Asmat Ishta Devatavyo Namaha. So you all know what we are going to do? Anyone can answer? This is called Nitya Puja. Puja means like prayer, okay? Nitya means daily. So daily, what we can do to our gods in form of prayer in two places. One is at your home, correct? And second is in a temple, like religious place, public place like temple. So Nitya Puja workshop for all the grown-ups like you all children. Now, we have to start with a prarthana, prayer mantra. So just say, Guru Brahma,
Guru Brahma,
Guru Vishnu,
Guru Vishnu,
Guru Devo,
Guru Devo,
Maheshwara,
Maheshwara,
Guru Sakshat,
Guru Sakshat,
Parabrahma,
Parabrahma,
Tasmai,
Tasmai,
Gurave,
Gurave,
Namaha,
Namaha.
So, we are all going to do this puja with some knowledge, correct? We can't do anything without any knowledge. Even to eat, you need to have a knowledge, right? So, that knowledge goddess is called Saraswati in our Hindu religion. So, we'll start with the prayer to Saraswati. Just repeat. You don't worry if you don't, you don't need to memorize and all. That's all your responsibility of your parents to make you memorize at home later in the coming days. So, just repeat this. Saraswati, Namastubhyam, Varade, Kamarupini, Vidya, Arambam, Karishyami, Siddhir, Bhavatme, Sada, Prano, Devi, Saraswati, Vatevir, Vachinivati, Dinam, Avi, Trevadu, Om, Vatevye, Samaha. So this is the prayer for Saraswati. So what you are saying is, Saraswati, the goddess of all knowledge, I am going to learn this Nitya Puja. Kindly, and this is a new Vidya. Vidya means a curriculum, education. So some have a engineering, medicine, business. That's a curriculum stream. Like that, this Puja is one of the stream. I am going to learn this Vidya means it's a skill. I am going to start from now, Arambam. So for this, it should come all in a nice manner. So kindly bless. Okay. Then we have another god who revealed all the Vedas. We have Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharvana Veda. It is all revealed by Lord Vishnu in form of a god called Hayagriva. So we will pray for Hayagriva as well. So Jnana, Anandamayam, Devam, Nirmala, Spadiga, Shutim, Adharam, Sarva, Vidyanam, Hayagrivam, Upasmahe.
Upasmahe.
Now we have done the initial prayer. Now we will make it relax. Now, who you think is your supreme to all of you? Obviously, your parents. Correct? mom and dad. So what we say in our Vedas, just repeat this, Matru, Devo, Bhava, Pitru, Devo, Bhava. So what you are saying in Sanskrit is, my mother is my goddess, correct? Matru means mother, Pita means father. So Pitru, my father, is my god. So you are born with your mother and you came to know your dad. And they are teaching you both, right? Every day you wake up, you do all your regular customs in the morning, take shower, get nicely dressed, have a breakfast, go to school or play, and come back to lunch. And the evening you do other activities, some learnings or sports or whatever. How do you came to know all this? Is your mother and father doing everything? No. Correct? Your father has to go to office because that's his main profession. So what he says, you all go to school. So why? Mom, mother and father cannot do everything. So they send you to the school and you learn from teacher. Correct? So the teacher is the one, your father points to the teacher, and then you learn for all 13 years in different countries, different school, have a different curriculum. England is different, Scotland is different, India, US is different. You learn all the knowledge. That teacher is called Guru. So that Guru's another name is called Acharya. So the Acharya, without whom, if someone doesn't go to school or college or learn anything from the books, they won't know anything, right? So they are equivalent to God. So the next third one is, first one is Matru Devo Bhava, second one is Pitru Devo Bhava. Third one is therefore, repeat, Acharya, Devo Bhava. So my teacher is my God. So we are all going to be back to school next week. So they are your God. Not only teachers, your elders and your home, your grandmother, grandfather, this grandmother, that grandfather, your uncle, your mama, chitappa, maternal uncle, but all the other friends, they all give you some knowledge every time, right? Even Google is also a guru. So it's a Google guru. Okay. Now, fourth one. You have friends, classmates, and their mother, father is there, right? And your father, mother invites them. Oh, come, let's have, it's a summertime vacation. We'll have some lunch and dinner, nice time, correct? What do you call them?
Guests.
Yes, so you call them guests. So in Sanskrit, they are called Atithi. Say?
Atithi.
Atithi means guest. How do you treat your guest? Can anyone say? Kindly. Then? Yes? Okay. So you, yeah, tell me. Yeah. So you treat them kindly, you have nice time, you offer them all the food, all the pleasantries, give them sweets, snacks, nice lunch. You all play, right, with your classmates and friends. So they are also, you treat them as a god. So the fourth one is, after Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, fourth one just say Atithi Devo Bhava. You mean all your guests, you treat them as god and goddess are visiting your home. So now you repeat these four. Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava. Okay. I will come back to this Atithi after some gap. We'll take a break. Break means on the topic, not. So I told you, you came to know, you first your mother and father. How do they come? They come from their mother and father. Mom's mother and father, that's mom. So grandparents, right? How the grandparents came? Through their parents. So it keeps going, right? In everyone's life, you can actually see up to 7 generations. Can anyone believe? When I was born as a young baby, my father, mother, my father, mother's mother, there, grandparents, and their parents were there, right? And now I'm grown up. Now I have my son. And after 10, 15 years, he will get married, he will get his son. That will be my grandchildren. And after some time, say fingers crossed, if I live up to 180, 90 years, nowadays the life expectancy all over the countries are very high. And I can see their great grandchildren. So you will see 7 generations. 9 is the middle, 4th. I can see 3 to 1, my grandfather's side. I can see 5, 6, 7 towards my son and daughter. So 7 children. How they all came to know? How they all came? They were all born. They were all born in this world for generations. Right? So that is our Hindu religion tattva. Tattva means we are not born alone. We are not alone in this world. We are always with our parents, with our cousins, with our friends, with our grandfather, grandmother, grandchildren, everyone. Correct? So that is why we say Vasudha, say
Vasudha
Eva
Eva
Kudumbakam.
Kudumbakam.
The whole world is my family. Okay? So that is a tendency we should have whenever we meet any other person, your families, relatives, friends, even if you see some Europeans or Americans or any other nationality, you will feel they are our large family. So that is another tattva philosophy of our Hindu religion, Vasudhaiva Kudumbakam. Okay. Now how they all came to know, we are all born, we are all created. Which means, we are all born where? We are all born on this planet? Earth. How is this earth is surviving? Can anyone know quickly, one of the boys, girls? How is the earth is surviving? What will, when something stops, which will shut the whole world? Very good. If I stop the Google server goes crashed. Nothing will happen, right?
Yeah.
You will be no exams, no studies, no job, like that. The sun goes, earth cannot survive. Which means, young baby, can it survive without its mother? No. So all the children must be, you should pray, must be blessed with their mother and father all the time until they become mature adult, right? Like that, this earth must be blessed with the sun every time. Not just now in the daytime, it's evening 6 o'clock, it's going to get dark, it's a night time, I don't want sun. No, sun is still shining on the other part of the world, correct? So sun is here every moment. So the one which cannot survive even for a fraction of moment is supreme. Without which he cannot survive. Can I survive without a water? No, I need to drink water every 3 hours, every 4 hours, right? Like that, the whole planet Earth cannot survive without the sun shining. So that is equivalent to your God. So we can see that. Can someone say, have you seen the God? You can say, yes, I'm seeing the God. He is Surya Narayana. Surya, Lord Sun, is the God. Now go further. Who created the sun? Sun, we all know, is another one star, correct? In the night time, here it's always cloudy, but when you go India or nice tropical countries, in the night time, it's pitch dark. Go to your native countryside. You see hundreds, millions of stars. So every star is a sun. Sun is the nearest one. They are even further, million, billions of miles away. They keep shining, right? Who all created that? So the simple logic is, if there is a creation, there must be a
creator.
Okay? So for now, we will do things like this. There is a creator. And every religion, Hinduism, Muslim, Islam, Christian, Buddhism, Chinese, Judaism, everyone, they attribute that particular creator as a God. Okay. Now, we have in our thing, 3 main gods, like you said. Yes, tell me.
Shiva.
Okay. Now, can someone say what is a Shiva meant for? No, you have already said, another opportunity. Yeah, tell me. No. Yes, one is will make destroy. Why to destroy? There is nothing like destroy. The stars, they go in cycle. They shine for millions of years and they go back slowly like a black hole. Whoever is interested in astronomy can study. And it will die away and it will reborn. So that's why we say the whole cosmic universe, this prapancha in Sanskrit, will be born like a big bang and it will go as a big crunch. But nothing to worry, it will take millions of billions of years. And it goes in cycle. To do that, we need one powerful person. That person is Lord Shiva. Then what is Brahma? Yes, Mukund.
Creator.
So someone needs to, so the one cycle goes, right? So then after that, destroy is called, it doesn't destroy. It shrinks, it becomes very subtle form. You know, when there's a very big banyan tree, it's huge tree, you cannot see all those what's happening. No one has seen the fruit of banyan tree. It won't be visible. The seed is very, very small. That seed is so small, but when you plant in a nice new plant, it will germinate, become a very big tree. That seed giving germination is done by Brahma. So it's called Srishti. Srishti means creation. When destroy means all things will again go back to that small seed, is called not destroy, we say in Sanskrit layam. Layam means one it is going inside into something in a very subtle form. Now, so you have a Srishti, you have a final layam, the yam. In between, what is happening? I will give opportunity for someone else. Shiva, we have told, Brahma, we have said, yes. Yes, preserving. So if the child is born, it has to be given milk, it has to be given food, it has to be made to walk, run, eat food all the time, learn something, all those things. When you do, there are some always dangers, right? When you walk across the road, there is a chance if you follow the, don't follow the signal, the vehicles will come and hit. So someone has to protect you. That protection role is done by the god Vishnu. So we have Brahma for creation, Srishti, Vishnu for protection, it's called Sthiti. And Shiva for destroy towards the end as a Laya. Now, all these gods, now we have different gods we have in our Hindu religion. Like, you know, you have a prime minister cannot do everything. So he has a defense minister, finance minister, commerce minister, environmental minister, health minister, all like that. We all got different forms. That's all you can read in the different stories. You can ask your parents. Of that, one of the another prime god, we say Ganapati, Ganesha. So that's what you can see here, Ganesha. And then you have Vishnu. Now, I'll go back. You said Matri Devo Bhava, Pitri Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava, right? Atithi is your guest. How will you treat your guest when you call for a lunch or dinner? Like you said, kindly. Can someone elaborate? From the beginning, they call your phone, your dad. Dad invites you. My son, daughter wants to play with your children. Can you all come? Then they fix a date. This Sunday, 11th August, 5 p.m. in the evening. From that moment, can someone say, when the guest arrive at your, in front of your home, what and all you'll be doing? Yeah? Next, yes? Yeah? That is before. Okay, next. Cleaning, welcoming, after welcoming, will they go back again? I'll just come, okay, welcome, okay, thank you, bye. No, what is after welcome?
Invite them inside.
Yes, correct. They are coming inside. Next, imagine it's a very Scottish weather, lot of rain and stormy. Okay, so you are inside. Next. Correct. Sit down then. Fruits? Okay, very good. Next, you give them some fruits. So like this. Now, they have another most important entity. I just told you, the God, the Creator. We cannot perceive the Creator, how He looks, how He appears. So, therefore, our Hinduism has made it simple, right? I can see my mother, father, my relatives, like all of you, like that they made. We are humans. Like that, our Hindu religion have made the God can be perceived in our form of human with supreme powers. So, they also will appear like human with hands, legs, all the weapons and things to protect, to destroy all those things. So they are like a gods, our guests. Now imagine, when you get your family, friends as a guest, like you said, welcome them, they will come inside, ask them, like in India, it's very hot, can you please wash your hands and legs? We all know that since our COVID lockdown, what is the importance of being clean and hygiene? So if they do, then you give them, do you want coffee or tea? Can you take some fruits, right? And then you say, I got a nice dress for you, can you go and have a shower, come back. Like if they are staying over for a Christmas or long weekend, they take a shower in your home. And then you give them a nice dress. And then you have a food, lunch or dinner. And then you have a nice conversation. Children, they get to play monopoly or whatever it is. Go outside in the park, you play, and then you discuss, and then you go. Like that, if you want to invite your God, what he will do? That is what we are going to do now. Don't worry about how we do. Just observe. And if the time permits, you will be able to do today. But we have two people. One is Sriram. He will say, he will show you how to do a Nitya Pooja for Ganapati, Ganesha. Sri Vatsan will say the same, repeat, show you how to do a Pooja for Vishnu. So you can see Ganapati and Vishnu, okay? How will you do? Like I said, all these steps, there are 16 steps of inviting the gods. And then you do the Pooja. After all the 16, you will do the prayer. When you are visiting, you are inviting your guest, say if there is a very elderly person like a grandmother, grandfather, you ask them, please bless me. Next week I am going back to school. I am starting my primary one, or I am starting my university, or I am starting my secondary school. You bless them, right? Like that, you seek blessing. Like that, you ask blessing. Okay, that's what we will do. So now you all can start slowly following how they are going to do. It will be like each for them 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, there will be small chanting. Yeah, thanks. So, can you come here, Sriram?
She will say.
So what is the most important thing we need to do this time? All of you, both the gentlemen and ladies, boys and girls, in our sampradaya Hinduism, you must have some form of mark on the forehead, because there is a holy seven chakras, and this is called Ajna chakra, between your two eyebrows. That is the point of your focus and concentration. So that is why we have in our tradition to put your chandan or kumkum or some kind of mark on this. Okay. So now you can see both Sriram and Srivatsan, they have. Maybe I will just tell them, for Sriram, little bit kumkum is most important. Okay. That's good. So you need to first have a shower, have a nicely dressed, and put some tilak. A tika, bindi, whatever you call it. So once you have that, have a nice dress. It is good to have a traditional dress. They have in dhoti and shirt, like in skirt, kilti, or anything. But you have to be well decently dressed, because you are doing something for your gods. Okay. So now you start inviting them. So I will tell you in English, then it is easy for you to follow. What Sri Ram Srivatsan is going to do is, they are coming inside. So you are offering them a chair. Chair is, we call asana. And for anything, you cannot really bring a chair now, right? So what do? You have something called akshada. So you all can see, right? The yellow rice. It's just a normal rice what we have. They mix with turmeric powder and little ghee, it becomes yellow. It's called, can you say akshada? So maybe some of your friends' name is akshada, okay? So that akshada, when you do like this, take very little and do like this. Okay, this is what you will do. Normally like three fingers, can you do like this, what you call, rabbit face? Yeah, these three fingers. So do like this and do, okay? That's the way you have to do. So first you offer them a chair. So can you say this word, samarpayami? Samarpayami means I am offering. I am offering this chair to you. Asanam samarpayami. Say they come here. And the gods come and stand. What you do? You ask them to wash their feet, because they are very elder, they are creator, right? So he says, pada means foot, right foot and left foot, right? So pada means they will touch the foot of the god, padyam. So offer a little bit of water, like washing your feet, and then wash your hands. Argyam means like giving a water into your hands. So you can say argyam, they will do. And then you give them some water to drink. So you say achamaniyam means drink water three times. So they will give water. So what I have kept here is, there is one small water, pure water. Normally we add some tulasi. And then whatever you offer, you take this as a prasad, blessings from themselves. So you need to have a collector vessel, minimum two vessels. One is the supply, and you show like this and you put it here. Finally, this will be become a theta prasad. You all have seen before, towards all the puja is done, we stand here and give theta, right? That one. So you will be drink. Then you ask them to take shower. So you put little bit of water like a snanam. Snanam means shower, abhishekam. Then again you drink, ask them to drink water. Then you give new clothes, new vastra, new jewels, like all the gold and the diamonds. And then you give new upavita, like a punal, yajyopavita. So you all offer in form of akshada, because I can't do now, it will take more time. And then you ask them, like I said, after taking shower, everyone puts a teeth, right? So like that, you ask God, can you please add on the kumkum and the haldi, the turmeric. Then you give a very incense, nice sandal, sandal paste. So there is a sandal paste, sandal powder paste. Then after this, you give some nice flowers. You can, I have just put flowers already, they will give some flowers. And then again you give this akshada rice as a offering. And then you do archana. Archana means praising basically. Oh, what one of your name like, Dhriti? Oh, you are so nice, you are beautiful, you are lovely girl, you are so obedient, you are so studious. Then you get pleased, oh, my mother is, then you beg, you can blush and you get, tell me. Like that, if you ask Ganesha and Vishnu, Lakshmi, Durga, Saraswati, Hanuman, Hanuman, you are so marvelous, you are courageous, you have saved Rama, Lakshmana, you have rescued, identified Sita, you have crossed the ocean, you can lift the Parvata like mountain, like anything, you have been friend with Bhima, and you have all done these things. Like that, then Hanuman will become pleased. Oh, okay, my devotee, what do you want? Then you say, I want good marks, I want good knowledge, I want my friends and relatives all be very good, I want this world, universe to be peaceful. Then you will say, okay, I will grant, I will be with you. So that is archana. So they will do some archana for Ganesha and Srivatsan do for Vishnu. So that is one another form. Then after all this, you do naivedya, because that is the most important. You have to give them lunch and dinner. So we have now some fruits and the milk. So we will get some fruits and then they will do naivedya. At that time, sometimes you have seen all through this time, we ring this bell. Do you know why? Anyone? Now you are also attentive, you are looking more like a classroom, very nice. But doesn't happen all the time, right? So people will be chanting something, they'll, yeah, I have seen this cricket score, blah, 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 all those things, right? But when there's an important puja is happening, they need to be attentive. That is the symbol saying, I'm ringing the bell, don't talk yourself, pay attention. And also they may be discussing something else. This is one of the Mangala Vadhyam, means it's very auspicious. So the ring, the vibration of the bell in the this brass metal, it gives a good vibration to all the environment, whether it is at home or in the temple. Now, so now you can all see what you will do at the home. Okay, now you are in temple, I got this big Ganesha and all those things. Some of you in your home you may already have, but just for demonstration, I brought it from my home. Okay. Can you see who is this? Hanuman. Right? So now you can ask your parent at home, oh, I'm going to temple only in Sundays. What I can do every day? Every day morning or every day evening? So you may have something like this. You don't need to have exactly like this, it can be a photo. Simple, if you don't have anything, ask your dad, get me a A4 printout photo. Then you keep like this. This is Hanuman. Okay? Now, who is this? Most favorite for everyone. Kutti Krishna. Yes, little just born baby Krishna. Okay, everyone will have this in your homes. And the next one, the most famous. This is Lord Tirupati Govinda Venkateshwara. So you can see this in the big picture over there and the small form Utsava here. So Venkateshwara, Venkata Chalapati. So like this you can ask in your home. Everyone we have definitely. Only thing you need to know, ask your mom and dad, where is a puja room? Do I have a puja room? No, that's not okay. Is there a puja shelf in the kitchen in some corner? Yes, there is a puja shelf. No, there is no puja shelf. Okay, what you can do? you have your study table, right? Small table, play table, gaming table, whatever it is. Ask them a small photo printout, or get this when you go to India next time. Get this small thing, they are very cheap. You get here, also we have some in our stores, at the counter. When you go to Hindu Mandir, you will find. When you go to Birmingham Temple, you will find. When you go to Leicester, London, you get everywhere. In the worst case, order in eBay or Amazon, simple. Okay, so that's how we have. So you can do this puja, like what Sri Vatsan and Sri Ram is going to do, you can try to do. So now we'll start now. Okay, thanks. Can you come here? So what I said first, you have to wash your hands. Most hygiene is the most, just wash. Come, give me the dinner. Okay. Just pray. Om.
Om.
All, everything, as I said, mother, father is the most first knowledge giver. The next one is your acharya, teacher. So first pray for your teacher. Om.
Om.
Asmat.
Asmat.
Guru Pyo.
Guru Pyo.
Namaha.
Namaha.
And you all have come from some place, some native place, somewhere in India, South India, North India, West, or in the Kerala, Tamil Nadu, whatever. You have a native village. That's where all your ancestor, your grandfather, mother live. They have worshipped certain temple. So that temple devata is called Kula Devata. So you have to worship, think of that village. Om.
Asmat.
Asmat.
Kula.
Devata Vyo.
Namaha.
Om Asmat.
Om Asmat.
Ishta.
Devata
Vyo.
Namaha.
Om Asmat.
Om Asmat.
Pratana.
Devata
Vyo.
Namaha.
Okay, now they are going to meditate. First, one of the most important, when we say Vishwaksena, the very first, the chief in commander, or Ganapati seeking permission. So you start with this Om.
Om.
Shuklam.
Shuklam.
Paradaram.
Paradaram.
Vishnam.
Vishnam.
Sashivarnam.
Sashivarnam.
Chaturbhujam.
Chaturbhujam.
Asannavadanam.
Asannavadanam.
Yayete.
Yayete.
Sarvavigna.
Sarvavigna.
Upashantaye.
Upashantaye.
Yasyadvirata.
Yasyadvirata.
Vaktratyaha.
Vaktratyaha.
Parishadyaha.
Parishadyaha.
Parasatam.
Parasatam.
Vignam.
Vignam.
Nignanti.
Nignanti.
Satatam.
Satatam.
Vishvachainam.
Vishvachainam.
Tamasraye.
Tamasraye.
Now you just say Om. Vakratunda. Mahakarya. Kodi Surya. Samaprabha. Avignam. Kurume Deva. Sarva. Karvyeshu. Devata. So he worshipped to Lord Ganapati. Whatever I am going to do, let it be without any break, without any obstacle, without any hurdles, go smoothly. For that, give your blessing. Okay, that's what he has now started praying for Ganapati. Don't think too much. Oh, he's saying so many things. It's all complete. No. Just the essence you need to understand. How to worship, what form of the love and affection you need to show. That is called bhakti. How much devotedness you can be, and how they do. Just observe. Then we will continue later on how to do it. Okay. Now, I want someone to ring the bell because we are all chanting, right? But I will ring only once. I will tell you, I will give it to one of you. When they do, I want you to follow. So at this time, symbolically I start, but when they do, I'm not going to ring the bell because you cannot hear when I talk. So I'm going to be on mute. The bell is going to be on mute. Om. Just take this. Both of you. Take little akshara. Om.
Om.
You say Mahaganapati. You say Narayana. Om Mahaganapataye Namaha Asanam Samarpayami. Om Narayanaya
Namaha
Asanam Samarpayami. So you all can follow, right? He said, I am going to do a puja for Ganapati. Mahaganapataye Namaha. I am giving you, offering the seat. He said, Lakshmi Narayanaya Namaha. I am offering the seat. Okay. Now, next one, the washing the feet. Just take here. No. Om Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha Padyam Samarpayami. Show and put it here. Take one more. Padyam Samarpayami. Right and left leg. Just Swami Sabha. Om Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha Argyam Samarpayami. Right hand. Argyam samarpayami iti. Now he is going to drink three times. Om Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha. Om Achamaniyam Samarpayami Achudaya Namaha. Three times. Anantaya Namaha. Govindaya Namaha. Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Snanam Samarpayami. So he is giving you a shower, like a holy shower. After shower, again drink three times. Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Snanantaram Achamaniyam Samarpayami. Achyudaya Namaha. Anantaya Namaha. Govindaya Namaha. So he did the offered the seat, washed the foot, the holy lotus feet of the Ganapati, and gave water for agyam and for drinking, shower, another drinking water. Now, same thing. Sri Vachana is going to. Om Sri Narayanaya Namaha. Om Padyam Samarpayami. Om Padyam Samarpayami. Om Narayanaya Namaha. Argyam Samarpayami. Om Narayanaya Namaha. Achamaniyam Samarpayami. Achyudaya Namaha. Anantaya Namaha. Govindaya Namaha. Om Namo Narayanaya Namaha. Snanam Samarpayami. When you do snanam, there are some Vedic mantras we will chat, but we will do it later. Now, Om Namo Narayanaya Namaha. Snanantaram Anchavaniyam Samarpayami. Om Achyudaya Namaha. Om Anantaya Namaha. Om Govindaya Namaha. So they have done all the way up to Abhisheka. Now Sriram is going to do. Take Akshada. Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Snanantaram. Now say Vastra. Upavita. Avaranani. Akshadan. Samarpayami. So what are you saying? After the shower, please have new dress. Vastra. Upavita, like this poonal Yajyopavita. Third one, Avaranani, all the jewels. I am giving all this in the form of Akshada. Okay, now you take. Now take Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Haridra Kumkumam Samarpayami. So he is giving turmeric haldi powder and Kumkumam. Now he is giving Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Gandhan. Gandhan means sandal wood paste. Gandhan Samarpayami. Gandhadvarangurādakṣāṁ nityapuṣṭāṁ kaleśinīṁ eśvarīgaṁ sarvabhūtāṁ āntvāṁ yopakvaye śriyaṁ Om Gandhān samarpayāmi. So he has done the Gandhān. Now, can you repeat the same thing? Om Sri Narayanaya Namaha. Snānāntaram Vastra Uttariya Āvaranāni Akṣadān samarpayāmi. Om Sri Narayanaya Namaha. Haridra Kumkumam Samarpayami. Om Narayanaya Namaha. Akshadan Samarpayami. So they have offered all the decorative items. You all do makeup, right? That's what they did just now. So now you do. Take Akshada. Now you take Akshada. Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Akshadan Samarpayami. He is giving the holy Akshada. Om Narayanaya Namaha. Akshadan Samarpayami. Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Just say Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. Pushpani. Just keep a flower. Pushpani Samarpayami. So he is giving flower. Om Namo Narayanaya Namaha. Pushpani Samarpayami. Okay, now they are going to do Archana. So you have this. So you take, like when you have in your garden, you maybe some flowers or you can buy in a shop. You don't need this much at home, this very little is fine. So like this. So Sriram is going to do like this, hold his plate. when I say, do it like this. If possible, you can repeat. It's not very long, okay? Om Mahaganapataye Namaha Archanam Samarpai Hami. This is very big actually. Sagastra Namam. Namam, no, you don't have, just explain, sorry. Sagastra Namam means the various names. I'm having only one, my name, Steve Narasimhan. No one, my parents didn't keep my second name. He has two names, Srivatsan and Yadu. Like that, all of you has. But God has various names. Sagastra means 1,000. So they have 1,000 names. So we can say 1,000 names now. It will take another 20 minutes. Can I have a short form? 108. It will take 8 minutes. Can I have a still short form? Some people they do 32. Some people they do 16. Some people they do 12. Minimum 12 is reasonable. 1, 2, 3 to 12 doesn't take much time. Hardly less than 2 minutes. So he is now going to say 18 names of Ganapati. So you all can repeat. Om Sumukaya Namaha. Om Yekadantaya Namaha. Om Kapilaya Namaha. Om Gajakarnaya Namaha. Om Lambodaraya Namaha. Om Vikataya Namaha. Om Vignarajaya Namaha. Om Vinayakaya Namaha. Om Dhumaketave Namaha. Om Ganadhyakshaya Namaha. Om Balachandraya Namaha. Om Om Gajananaya Namaha. Om Vakratundaya Namaha. Om Surpakarnaya Namaha. Om Kherambaya Namaha. Om Skandapurvajaya Namaha. Om Siddhi Vinayakaya Namaha. Om Sri Maha Ganapataye Namaha. So he got that 18 names of Ganapati. Okay. So now we will do similarly for Vishnu. Narayana, Vishnu, all the same. Om Sri Narayanaya Namaha. Om Narayanaya Namaha. Vasudevaya Namaha. Om Sankarshanaya Namaha. Om Aniruddhaya Namaha. Om Pradyumnaya Namaha. Om Keshavaya Namaha. Om Narayanaya Namaha. Om Vasudevaya Namaha. Om Madhavaya Namaha. Om Govindaya Namaha. Om Vishnave Namaha. Om Madhusudanaya Namaha. Om Trivikramaya Namaha. Om Vamanaya Namaha. Om Sridharaya Namaha. Om Rishikeshaya Namaha. Om Padmanabhaya Namaha. Om Dhamodaraya Namaha. Om Matsyaya Namaha. Om Kurmaya Namaha. Om Varahaya Namaha. Om Nrisimhaya Namaha. Om Vamanaya Namaha. Om Sridharaya Namaha. Om Rishikeshaya Namaha. Om Sri Vamanaya Namaha. Om Bhargava Ramaya Namaha. Om Ramaya Namaha. Om Balaramaya Namaha. Om Krishnaya Namaha. Om Kalkine Namaha. Om Seaman Narayana Charanau Charanam Kapatye Srimate Narayanaya. So that is concluded Archana for Ganapati and Narayana. Now what we have to do is give them, continue with the same thing. Just say Dhupam, we are offering Dhupam. Okay, just say, hold this. Om Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha Dhupam Samarpayami. Om Dhur Vadurvan Tandur Vadanyo Osma Dhur Vadikandur Vayandur Vamaskvan Devanamadi. Now he will do. Narayanaya.
Namaha.
Om.
Om.
Dhupam. We will do after the dupa, it is called deepa. Okay. Deepa. Om Sri Mahaganapatiye Namaha Deepam Samarpayami. So now he is doing the Deepa carefully. You can just do in a slow manner, but my main advice is, if you are doing at home, don't do yourself. You must have your mother or father or someone adult to support you. Do it with both of you holding hands. Okay, now you do. Om Ganana Antwa Ganapati Mahamame Kavinda Vinamo Vamasra Vastavan Yetara Jam Brahmana Brahmana Spatana Svendan Nirjavisti Dasadanam Om Sri Mahaganati Pataye Namaha. Om, like this he is going to do for Vishnu. Om Om Vishnave Namaha Deepam Sandrashyami. Om Tad Vishnu Paramam Patagum Vishnu of Paramam Patagam Sata Pashyanti Surayaha Divi Vachakshura Tadam Tadvi Praso Vipanyavuja Nubhagam Sasamindate Vishnu Yat Paramam Padam. So now they have done the Deepa Aradhana. The whole thing is called Aradhana, means worship. The whole 16 steps is called Aradhana. So one part of this is a Deepa. Now we do the most important thing, offering the food, Naivedya. So we have here fresh milk. And then we have some fruits. So now we will slowly drink. At this time, we have to ring the bell. So can you take this one? First, you purify. Take little water and pull. Om Bhurbhuvasuvaha. Om Sri Mahaganatipataye Namaha. Kshiram Nivedayami. Take it closer here. Just keep it. So you can, when you are offering any food, Naivedya, just keep it on the table or floor. You don't need to hold all the time. Okay, just do like this with the same, again, three fingers. So do like this, okay? Like you are feeding a small baby, okay? Like this, hold it like this, yeah. Om slowly. Om Satyam Tvartena Parishinchami Amrita Ubastaranam Asi Om Pranaya Swaha Apanaya Swaha Dhyanaya Swaha Udanaya Swaha Samanaya Swaha Brahmanima Atma Amritatvaya Om Amrita Abhi Dhanam Asi Om Guru Vasubaha. Now you offer some water. After drinking, after food, you take water, right? Om Ganadipataye Namaha Bhojanantaram Achamaniyam Samarpayami. Om Achyuta Yanamaha. Three times. Ananta Yanamaha Govinda Yanamaha. Om Bhojanantaram Phalam Nivedayami. Hold this in it. Phalam Nivedayami. Just do like this. So we are done the Naivedya. Now Sri Vatsan will do the same thing. Om Kurdu Vasuvaha. Om Sri Narayanaya Namaha. Om Kshiram. Satyam Tvartena Aparishinchami Amrita Upastaranamasi. Om Pranaya Swaha. Apanaya Swaha. Vyanaya Swaha. Udhanaya Swaha. Samana Yaswaha Om Brahmanima Atma Amrita Tvaya Om Amrita Abhijana Masi Bhojana Antara Mundrakul Achamaniyam Samarpayami Om Achyuta Yamaha Om Ananta Yamaha Om Govinda Yamaha. Irititam Prakshu Bhojana Antaram Phalam Nived Pratamil Phalam Nivedayami Om. So, we have done the Naivedya. Finally, we will do another Aarti. So, just say Om Mahaganadipataye Namaha Bhojanantaram Karpura Nira Janam Samarpai Amitune. This home. Just say Vakratunda, Mahakarya, Kodi Surya, Samarpaha, Avignam, Eva, Sarva, Bhagi Shu, Sarvata. Like this, Stevenson is going to do Om Narayana Yamaha, Bhojanantaram, Katpura, Nira Janam Samarpayami, Om Narayanaya, Vidmahe, Vasudevaya, Dhimahi, Tanno, Vishnuhu, Prachodayat. Okay, so this completes all the 16. Showed us a Upachara, various form of offering God, who is your Aditi again, guest in a form. So first, just to recap, giving an asana, the chair, one, two, washing the feet, third, washing the hands, four, to drink the water, five, for shower, snanam, six, for another drinking the water, seven, for giving the dress, upavita and jewels, eight, for haridra, kunkumam, nine, for gandham, the sandal paste, 10, for flowers, pushpa, 11, for akshada, 12, for archana, we did all the Keshava Narayana archana, 13, for dupa, incense sticks, sambrani, 14, for deepam, arati, 15, for naivedyam, 16, for another arati. So it's exactly 16. Okay, now we will do the final prarthana mantra. When you do prarthana mantra, when you are in the school, you learn something from your teacher. And do you forget everything? No. What they do for you not to forget, they conduct exams. So exams or some competition, some oral thing, all these things, right? Like that, in front of God, you have to chant or recite what you learned so that He will be happy. Okay, at least my children is knowing something. He is able to sing, he is able to chant, he is able to dance, he is able to do bhajan, all those things. So we normally start with Veda. So now, without wasting time, what I want, Sri Vatsan is going to chant small portion of Vedas, like a prarthana. At that time, I want all the children stand here, come in the queue. You do a very simple puja without taking much time. Okay. What and all you are going to do is, I will hold this arati. You all can come, two people in a time. Okay, two of you. Do like this. Give it to me. Then you go back and sit. Okay, can you all come in two each? One each single. So now Sri Vatsan is going to start the Vedas. So all of you please just follow what I say and follow what Sri Vatsan is chanting. So you can sit. Follow my speech.
Oh,
so there are two things. Sri Vatsan is going to chant Vedas, and after that, Sri Ram is going to chant a song. Bhajan. So you all come there. Come there. Angava apaktava. Give a name to the soldier. I will do yes, you will go. Om Shanno Mitra Shankarunaha
Shanno Bhavatvaryama Shanna Indra Brihaspatihi Shanno Vishnuru Rudramaha Namo Brahmane
Namaste. How do you receive? That's the main thing, right? Because he's an elder. From the God, you need to be with a lot of humbleness. Everyone, all of us, even the big, small children, should have the humility, humbleness. So can you all do like this? How will you feel? Some people, I say, when I give water, do like this. It's all very confusing. So what you have to do is, can you all repeat? Left hand to the center. Left hand to the center. All fingers closed. And on the top of left hand, right hand. Okay, and it should be like this. Oh. You should have a small shallow so that you can take the seeds, the prasada, or milk. Okay, so do like this. You are not going to do now, but I am just demonstrating how to do when you are getting the final prasada. So do like this and do take this and you will have something. Now you can't do like this, then you have to give respect. So just wipe it in your top of the head. Okay? Next one, you have the Lord Vishnu's holy feet. So you got like that on the head. So at that time you should not do like this or whatever. Just fold your hands and bow your head. When you do like this, that chadari, it's called chadari, they will touch on your head. Until then you should be like this. After this you come. Then you take flower, like this flower, okay, in your hand. And they will give you this fruits or whatever, okay. That's how everyone should do. Now, can you all say this final Mangala slogan? Okay. Sriyaha.
Srinivasaya Mangalam.
What have you come? Sriram. Srivatsa. Kayena Vacha. Manasa. Indriya Iva. Buddhi. Atmanava. Prakrute. Bhavat. Karomi. Yajyat. Sakalam. Parasmai. Narayana Yeti. Samarpayami. So you are saying, whatever I have done, I might have done some mistake. I don't know the correct. I might have spoken you wrong with all the grammatical mistakes, everything, right? You don't get the 10 out of 10 in your exam. So you are saying, please forgive me. Whatever you have done is for you only. So say Sarva, Sri, Krishna, Samarpanam, Vastu. Okay, now that's fine. So this concludes the puja workshop. Now we are going to do the final part which is called Saraswati Puja. All of you are back to school from next week, Monday onwards, whatever, wherever you are in Glasgow or other council. Now what I want from the parents is, whoever want to do Aksharabhyasam, first time they are going to the school, I think you all have brought writing pad or two or whatever it is. Please go to counter, you need to pay £10 for that Aksharabhyasam. And for Archana, I think it's a normal ticket, check in the counter, whoever wants to do Archana. And whoever is starting the Aksharabhyasam, please come in the same place but facing the Saraswati the other way. Okay. All the other children, grown up or whatever, you can just be yourself, you are free now. But if you like the workshop, we will do one more workshop later in October holidays around Navaratri time. After 1 or 1.5 months. Depends on your interest, and also we wish more children to come and join. Now it's all the children, you need to go and pester at home. Ask your mother and father, what puja I can do at home, in what way. That way you can do. Even if you don't do all this, you don't need to worry. You don't need to do all the 16. Just take a bath, put your tilak, go pray, small sloka, offer some flower, offer some milk, do the prostration and say, keep all of us blessed. Either in morning or in the evening. Okay, that is enough. Thank you.